35-year friend of mine.
Oh, well.
Mary Margaret Heath's son.
Is whose son?
Mary Margaret Heath.
Oh, well, see, you already know that your mother is revered here. And
I like
you. Yeah, you like her. We're glad that you did. It is wonderful to have you back home also. And pray that God will bless you in the midst of that. And I will congratulate you on your choice of friends. You've got a pretty good guy. It is great to have you.
Thank you.
It is always a joy to have people come back home and worship with us. And it is my prayer that some of those fond memories that you had when you were here, God will bring back to you in the midst of our worship. And Chris.
Yes, I have an announcement. Virginia Campbell asked me to announce that she is looking to form a Bible study, and if you think you might be interested in that, she is going to meet with those interested parties next Sunday after church.
Appreciate it. And she's already got three people who are interested, so we're excited about that. And so you'll meet with her next Sunday after worship in the library, which is where she planned on meeting. So. We do have a couple of thanks that we want to lift up to God. Chip Brainerd's uncle Chuck came through his surgery to remove a tumor on his lower lung. Doris Noble's procedure went well. She's getting stronger each day and a little less pain. And so the doctor said it will be a while after all the swelling goes down and that she should be back in good shape. And Jan and Gary's nephew is home safe from Afghanistan. And for that, we give thanks, and for all those who serve our nation's will across the world and get home safely for their family, we give thanks and praise to God. Are there others? If not, I invite you to set your hearts on God as Janet plays the prayer.
Thank you. rise and read the call to worship as possible. We rejoice in God's word like one who finds great joy.
We hate and abhor falsehood, but we love the law of the Lord.
Great peace have those who love God's law. Nothing can make them stumble.
We hope for your salvation, O Lord, and we fulfill your commandments.
Our souls shall keep your decrees. We love them exceedingly.
Let our pride come before you, O Lord. Give us understanding according to your word.
Let us give thanks to God as we gather around the word of life.
Mercy.
silence, let us confess our personal failure to wrestle with God's word when making decisions in our lives. Since all have sinned and fail short of the glory of God, they are now justified by His grace as a gift. Through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice and atonement by His blood, effected through faith. Hear the good news. Our confessions have been heard, and we are forgiven.
Thank you.
time of Exodus, God has called upon God's people to bring an offering, and the scriptures proclaim that everyone whose heart was stirred, everyone whose spirit was willing, brought the Lord's offering to be used for the tent of meeting, and for all of its service, and for the sacred vestments. May we do likewise.
Take our offering and use it to proclaim your